Starting next month, trusted testers will be able to try this and 6 more generative AI features across Workspace. And later this year, all of this will be generally available to business and consumer Workspace users via a new service called Duet AI for Workspace.
For those who didn't know, Google had their Google I.O. event yesterday, and essentially it went down a treat because mainly what was discussed was AI. Google are naturally in a race with OpenAI and Microsoft, which is a branch, I guess, of OpenAI's technology, and they're trying to catch up pretty rapidly. They introduced something called Duet AI, which I want to expand on in this video and give you an idea for how it could potentially change the Google Workspace environment and how they could expand it into pretty much every tool, which could be an interesting experience. Welcome to this channel. My name is Francesco. Welcome to Keep Productive. If you're new here, do subscribe. And if you want to check out all the productivity tools from around the world, you can check out Toolfinder linked below. We'll also have an article on Duet AI over there as well. So Duet AI is an experience that will be coming to Google Workspace later this year. They didn't really give a bit of context around it, but they also released a few other updates when it came to Workspace. And they were the likes of Help Me Write, which will live inside of Google Docs and Gmail, for helping you to improve drafting and crafting of documents. And they also improved the likes of Slides, and a new ability in Excel, it's actually Google Sheets, that essentially allows you to create workspaces or sheets or tables for you from a prompt, which is a neat feature that was actually initially sort of, I guess, brought to life with Coda AI that launched about a month and a half ago. So Google seemingly trying to catch up with a few elements here. But Duet AI seemed probably the most interesting element of this, and it lives in the top right-hand corner of your Google Workspace account. Now, they gave a few examples of how this could potentially work, and I'm not sure whether I heard it right, but I believe internally they're trying to call it Google Sidekick or something like that. But Duet AI, strange name for it, allows you to basically use a chat-like ability that scans whatever you're working on to improve what you're doing. So here's an example. They gave a good example of that they're writing a story with their niece, or I think it was, and they're crafting a piece that would essentially be about that story. Now you would pop this sidekick open from the top right-hand corner, and from here, you'll be able to basically see prompts and suggestions on the scan of the document. So in this case, they were at the point where they were struggling to produce the next line or creative hook that this might be about. And it offered two suggestions, the suggestion of what happens next and the suggestion of an image that can be crafted using what's in the document. So this is really interesting because it could help you to craft documents better and be able to pull resources that are in your Google Workspace account. Much like we're seeing with Microsoft CoPilot that has taken advantage of the 365 ecosystem, pooling stuff from the graph and bringing it into certain accounts and areas that you're using 365. So Google definitely getting some inspiration there when it comes to Duet AI, but definitely a good step forward. They also demonstrated how this could be powerful in Gmail as well, giving an example of, you know, organizing a neighborhood potluck, which I still don't know what is, but you can open this sidekick from the top right-hand corner and essentially helps you prompt based on the scan of the page and gives you some suggestions. So in this case, it might be like being able to pull some recipe ideas in there. And what it will do is not only take, what's on the page and be able to utilize the AI function, but it will take what you've already created in terms of the documents that are already in your account. Again, very similar to what Copilot is doing at Microsoft, but of course, definitely something I think a lot of people will find beneficial. So you can naturally utilize this function in Duet AI, but this is something that's quite exciting around the ecosystem of Google, is obviously you're not just thinking, okay, this Duet AI can live in Workspace, but imagine if they made something like this available inside of an experience like Google Chrome as an extension, or maybe via Android as well. This could live almost on the top of things and work with any app that you're utilizing to be able to organize, which sort of gives like a layer of AI on top of every app that has ever been created that utilizes generative elements. So whatever you're using, Google could have a layer over the top of it, which is pretty much what Google Chrome's business model is, I guess, is being the home to everything else. So Duet AI isn't expected till later this year, but they also gave a final demonstration of slides and how this experience could work. So opening up in slides, and you're in a last minute situation, you want to add speaker notes that are relevant to this with the context you've added in the slides, well, it can do that for you as well. So Duet AI, the goal of it is really to save you time on elements that you're already using, and works pretty much in a similar situation to Microsoft Copilot in allowing you to get enhanced experiences using Google Workspace Graph to pull out other experiences inside of those. So nothing ridiculously new with Duet AI, but we're seeing a common trend with Google and Microsoft at the moment, where tools like Coda, Catalog, Notion, and many more that are doing some interesting stuff with AI, Google and Microsoft are almost pinching these ideas and essentially implementing it on a larger scale with bigger distribution. This is really interesting to see, because are we going to see an evolution in where all of these third-party applications that present the concept just suddenly become too pressured because of the distribution of Google and Microsoft? Another example last week was Microsoft introduced new whiteboard AI functions with Copilot, which allows you to summarize what's on the board that you're demonstrating, visualize and suggest items as well, which is a really cool feature. But Miro have definitely been doing something like that for about a month and a half now, and naturally seeing that innovation and being able to implement it. So we're seeing third-party applications almost get their function being stripped from them. Now, of course, the argument is Google, Microsoft, not everyone wants to use them, and third parties will continue to rise. But in terms of AI innovations, the third-party marketplace is definitely doing much more than Google, Microsoft to be able to innovate faster than they are. But of course, there's a level of distribution and responsibility in that, and Google, Microsoft, and the other applications that are much bigger have that responsibility and much more of a user base to be able to try and warrant innovating fast from. But it's definitely interesting to see how Duet AI will evolve, and we'll get our hands on it as soon as we humanly can. but of course, if you're interested in exploring more trends like this, whether that's Microsoft Copilot or Google's Workspace, there will be a Google event next week, which will help us explore certain topics in there. So if you're interested, please do subscribe, and also check out Toolfinder if you're looking for the perfect productivity tool. Thank you very much, folks, and I'll talk to you all very soon.